Williams starts to develop on the left side. Beautiful shots just like that. She's got a beautiful little right hook that she throws. Mizar is able to land it. Mew is just beating it. She's got to be careful to keep those hands up as she starts to create these triangles. After she knows, she shoots, chains up to the top. And she got that clinch. That's exactly what she wants. Look for the headlock takedown or possibly a judo throw.
Dominant first round from Ayaka Miura. One time attempting the submission on Mayra Mazar.
Like how Mizar is defending that headlock. You can see that Miura wanted to wrap up the head with her left arm. She's, you know, looking for the headlock takedown now, but Mizar was able to defend for a little bit. Driving that head, and there's a good position to defend against this headlock takedown that Miura is known for.
Mizar does have an 8-centimeter reach advantage over Miura. No chance to use it at the moment. I'd like to see her get some distance and work that striking of her 6-3 pro kickboxing record on Ayaka Miura.
Sitting down to avoid the headlock. She might sit down a little too far. The balance shown by her so far as Miura's going for the headlock takedown again. That's a different way to do it. She just sits down and lands right into the headlock as well. She's doing the same thing that she's trying to do, she did in the first round. She's got a headlock. You can see how Mizar has wrapped up her leg around the leg, so she might be able to slide out, which is like one of the first escapes that they teach you in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu class, is how to escape a headlock. And this is one of the ways that they do it. Let's see if she can do it. They just go around, they try to sneak around the back, they try to pop their head out, so she ends up taking the back. Miura loves this position. She loves to grab hold of that head and just sort of hold people there looking for those submissions. One was the scarf hold key lock, which we saw in the first, and then she transitions to the arm triangle.
2 minutes 45 remaining. Second round of three. First round was all Ayaka Miura on the ground over Brazil's Mayra Mazar. Climbing up. Yep. That leg of Miura is Mazar from bottom position.
You can see Mazar's trying to sneak around and take the back. She's trying to go. There she goes, creates a scramble, but she might end up in a little bit of a worse position. Yep, this is exactly what Miura wanted. She's going to try to take that left arm, shove it down between her legs, and look for that key lock again. You can see that, you know, Mizar is very, very comfortable on the ground. She's doing all the right things. She's very tough, so you can probably tell that she's been in a lot of grappling exchanges where she's been put into bad positions. Over there, those world champions that evolved mixed martial arts. There's that key lock, though. Was he tapping or slapping her in the face?
I believe she tapped her out there. It's another submission in the second round for Ayaka Miura. 3-0 now with one championship. No one has lasted past the second round with her. She is a phenom, and she has sent a very clear message to Zhong Jinan that she may be coming for a tilt of the strap in 2020. Have a look at this. Here's the tap out from fifth and final round. The second chapter in this epic rivalry between Zhong Jinan and Angela Lee. Left hook early from Zhong. Goes to the body. Lee eats a left. Overhand right from Zhong. Zhong Jinan fakes the front kick off the back leg. Circles off to her left. Angela looking to control center circle. Maybe press Zhong back. Leg kick there from Angela. Oh, Zhong Jinan tried for a hammer fist strike and a short left hook. Angela presses her against the fence.
And this is where Angela is very dangerous now. She's got that body lock and she's also got that underhook on that side. She's going to try to press in. She's probably looking for a body lock takedown. She's looking to clasp her hands and spin Zhong Jinan back down to her backside.
Who will emerge? The women's atomweight world champion in 4 minutes and 10 seconds time. Will Zhong Jinan make history as a two-division world champion? Will Angela Lee defend in a division where she has been unstoppable?
Good defense from Zhong Jinan to work her way back away from the circle wall. She's trying to swim and get that underhook on the left side. That she does. Now she gets the body lock. Let's see if she can change the trajectory of this clinch and spin Angela Lee against the circle wall. No, she chooses to separate.
Oh! Zhong Jinan smiles and nods at Angela. You feel something big is coming from Zhong Jinan's hands very soon.
Man, something big's growing on the side of Zhong Jinan's head, though.
It's got its own zip code. Body shot there from Zhong Jinan. Angela, patient though, picking her openings, trying to thread the jab here, Angela Lee. Left hook, right hand, need a bit more start behind it there. And there's the start from the left hook again from Zhong Jinan. He's had more hooks for the Pirates convention.
Beautiful takedown defense. See if Angela Lee can finish or Zhong Jinan can circle out and take it back. Beautiful belly impact suplex by Angela Lee. Once she has that body lock on, it's a bad spot for Zhong Jinan. Angela Lee's got the back now. Let's see if she can dig in that second hook.
Halfway through the fifth and final round, Angela Lee giving it her all. And once again, Zhong Jinan needs to defend against a lady with a 78% finishing rate with 6 submissions in 9 wins.
You can see Angela Lee's trying to cradle that leg, trying to separate, possibly go for a banana split. This is where Angela Lee is so dangerous. She's got so many different submission opportunities. One of the owners of the only twister ever seen in one championship. See what she decides to do here. She tried to pull up that arm so she can slide that hook in. Zhong Jinan doing a good job of defending that hook. Angela Lee might not even need the second hook to secure a submission lock here.
They will be going.
I think she's gonna try to take that arm, lace it around her head, look for a twister.
They'll be going absolutely crazy in Hawaii at the moment on TNT for Angela Lee. Taking her time, elbow strike, and that was a wicked one above the left ear of Zhong Jinan. Again, Kennedy calls for the elbow, and Angela throws it. Again, the corner calling for elbows and punches from Angela. Still has the back of the strawweight world champion, does the atomweight world champion. The rivalry between these two, like nothing else in one championship. Tremendous respect for each other, but also a tremendous desire to triumph.
What a difference maker in the judges' scorecards right here, Michael.
Can Zhong find a way back to her feet? What's Angela looking for now, Dragon?
She's trying to separate. She's trying to take Zhong Jinan's left right arm, wrap it around her head, possibly look for a twister. But Zhong Jinan's wise to it. She's not allowing it to happen. But that was enabling Angela Lee to get both hooks into the legs there of Zhong Jinan. Now she's starting to pound her out. She's got 34 seconds.
Zhong Jinan has never been beaten in the championship.
In a final round.
Angela Lee choosing her mark, measuring her punches.
Oh, it's underneath.
Now for the choke.
That is.
Is this it?
18 seconds to go.
Is it over? She flips it out like a Chinese pancake.
Oh, it's underneath.
To get us underway, how long before this one between two grapplers goes to ground? Big overhead right there. Kisilova and the takedown from Nicolini.
Very easily ducked under that huge telegraph right hand. Slides over, easily passes the guard, almost zero resistance. Has the knee on belly. Kisilova's got to start pushing away. She can't just hold her there, but she's able to possibly get back into half guard. What? And Michelle Nicolini just kind of pushes it off.
What does Kisilova do with a human octopus on top of her? This is Nicolini's world. This is Nicoliniville. Any amount of options available for the 8-time BJJ world champion. And she drops some elbows. A little bit of ground and pound, softening up the Ukrainian. Another slicing elbow.
She might be looking for that arm. She's, or a head and arm triangle. The head and arm triangle is not really there. But she's trying to pass the guard here. She's going to slide that knee right through. Kisilova's in a bad. See, there's an arm triangle. If she just pops her arm out, it might be there.
Nicolini says she wants a chance at one championship gold. She wants to send a message tonight. And she says the victim has to be Irina Kisilova.
The see Kisilova just holding on to that head for dear life. Now Nicolini's looking to take the back. She might step over, yep, just like that. Now she's gonna flatten Kisilova out. Kisilova's gotta let go of that head. That's not, all it's gonna do is allow time for Nicolini to settle. She's gonna push those hands off of her head. Now she's in the full mount position. She uses the knee very wisely to break the grip of Kisilova.
Dropping elbows, dropping fists down on Kisilova as Michelle Nicolini from the full mount, the Brazilian. Not where you want to be. Fully mounted by Michelle Nicolini.
Kisilova's just...
Oh, she gives it back to Nicolini. This could be a cardinal mistake.
Headlock is her only defense, and easily Nicolini shrugs that off. That's like what they teach you in your first day of BJJ, is how to defend the headlock.
Oh, Nicolini, can she put the hooks in and fight out the very long body of Kisilova? She can. Is Kisilova going to give up? Is she going to tap out? She may be unconscious.
Beautifully done. That was just a BJJ clinic. Everything that you wanted to do right was done by Nicolini, but everything you wanted to do wrong was done by Kisilova.
The human NyQuil. She put her to sleep with a rear naked choke of the highest order. My word. Circle doors closed. Olivia Cost gets us underway. Third and final. Still anyone's for the taking. But momentum, you feel, is on the side of the Singaporean Tio. Jab. Has the big reach advantage over Miura. You hear the corner of Tiffany Tio saying, stay mobile, work the hands, use your boxing. You're a boxing champion.
You can see Akimura is trying to move. She's trying to keep her head off of the center line, but she's actually bobbing and weaving to the wrong side. You can see her shifting her head into the power side of Tio. If Tio can time it right, she might be able to connect with a big shot.
Loose, confident, fast, Tiffany Tio in her boxing tonight.
Oh, beautiful takedown defense from Tio. Nice and light on her feet, touching and moving.
Miura hunting after her, but being frustrated now, not able to get on the inside and put hands on Tiffany and take her down. And Tiffany keeps her at bay, keeps her at the end of her jab, the end of her leg kick. Good leg kick again there from Tiffany Tio. Mitch, you think that one of these two women could be a future opponent for Zhang Jinan? What goes through your mind? Do you feel Tiffany, do you feel Ayaka Miura would present the more problems for Zhang Jinan?
I think the more well-rounded game of Tio would give Zhang Jinan a little bit harder time, but we saw what happened the first time they met, and Zhang Jinan looked spectacular to kind of be the only blemish on Tiffany Tio's record. And in that matchup, it was a lot of back and forth action, but you could just see the power that Zhang Jinan had. And you know, that's the only time, you know, Tiffany Tio has ever been stopped. So I'm sure Tio would love to get the opportunity to run that back.
But Mitch, that was 2 years ago, and we are seeing a completely different martial artist tonight in Tiffany Tio.
Yeah, she's definitely used the time away. I mean, she's only competed, you know, once, you know, since that match with Zhang Jinan. This is her second matchup, but you can tell that she's made the necessary improvements. See, that's what I'm talking about. It's the way that Akimura is shifting her head. Tiffany Tio's able to time it. She just landed a head kick there. Akimura's got to change things up.
The kickboxing of Tiffany Tio tonight is superb. Roundhouse kick followed by a jab. It's all landing here for Tiffany Tio, and it's coming in combination. Not just single strikes from Tiffany. Sprawls out here, drops the elbows on the shoulder of Miura. Frustration creeping in now on Ayaka Miura. She can't hold Tiffany down, and Tiffany dances around the circle and continues to call forward the Japanese athlete. And how many jabs has Miura eaten tonight?
Yeah, Miura's getting touched up. She's at the end of the range, and she's just getting beat because she's not able to implement that one trick that we talked about, Michael. She's got that one go-to. She's not able to get the takedown. She's not able to wrestle her way into that position. And T.O. is relaxed and calm. The swagger is just oozing out of T.O. as she's keeping her at the edge of that jab and just consistently moving around.
The leg kicks now, breaking down the lead thighs of Ayaka Miura. Oh, beautiful threaded right hand, smack back to the orbital there from T.O. And another jab, and another outside leg kick. Ayaka Miura, no answers here for the striking of T.O. She's taken more jabs than a pin cushion. And there's another one to the jaw of Miura, and another jab to the cheekbone of Miura. It is all one-way traffic in the striking. It is all Tiffany T.O. tonight. With 1:05 remaining in the third and final round, how will Ayaka Miura swing the pendulum? Time is against the Japanese athlete, and she is tiring. Fatigue is setting in. She has been absolutely lit up on the feet. And yet another jab from T.O. The reach, the distance, the timing, and the snap of that jab again from T.O. doing damage. Miura can't get on the inside of it. T.O. calls her on. Miura shoots in for a low Sakuraba-style single leg. And T.O.'s going to knee her and going to strike her. There are the Hanafis strikes. Miura locking onto that leg. Only 20 seconds to go now. What a performance from Tiffany T.O. with the world champion Chongjin Nan circle side. T.O. sends a very strong message. Referee Olivia Cost says no more. Tiffany T.O. defeats Ayaka Miura and derails the Miura hype train. And she gets the applause from the champion.
Wow. Tiffany T.O. just extends her record to 9-1 with another impressive performance against a high-level grappler.
The one championship of New Era. 5 minutes remains for either Zhongjin Nan to retain or for Angela Lee to become an historic two-division world champion. Early trade of leather here. Zhongjin Nan showing damage around the right eye.
Angela Lee took two shots, shook her head, said, you got nothing on me. Zhongjin Nan's gonna need a big round if she's gonna wanna take this. Well, she has to go for the finish. Nice body kick. Angela Lee scrimmaged just a bit on it.
Side kick there from Zhongjin Nan. Oh, big overhand right, the knees almost went. Angela Lee's knees almost went. There was the power of the champion. She goes to the body.
Looks exhausted at this point. There's not a lot coming back from the atomweight champ.
And this is what Zhongjin Nan wanted. This was the game plan all along. Draw her into deep water and punish her in the fifth round. Let's see what Zhongjin Nan to do now.
I think Angela Lee might have blew her gas tank out when she went for that triangle armbar finish. She is, her mouth is wide open. She's taking big shots.
This is Zhongjin Nan's time. This is when she's going to go for it. She's going to pull out all the stuff. Throw caution to the wind. Angela Lee is blowing heavy. We've never seen Angela like this before. And here comes Zhongjin Nan with the overhand right. Another side kick. Straight into the guts of the atomweight champion. And a high hand. Angela's hurt. The body shot hurt her. The punching panda. Angela's in trouble. Angela's in trouble. It's over. It's over. It's good night, Irene. That was the plan. Take her into deep water. It worked. It's genius. It's brilliant. It's Zhongjin Nan. The unstoppable has been stopped.
The body shots. The body shots did it. She started kicking the body. You could see Angela Lee didn't have anything left in the fifth and final round. She put it all in to that triangle armbar finish. And when Zhongjin Nan was able to survive the fourth round, she came back and the flurry and still won strawweight world champion Zhongjin Nan.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.